Hello everyone, my name is SiC and welcome to a new series on Total War Warhammer. Now, most of the games that I play on my channel are kind of realism focused and this game is not that. But I've been playing Total Warhammer, Total War games ever since they came out. I started with the original Shogun, I played a little bit of Medieval, I played the hell out of Rome Total War, and I pretty much played every other Total War since. And I kind of burned out on them. It took me a very long time to purchase the Total War game that came after Rome. It took me quite some time to purchase Napoleon as well, because, well, it didn't feel quite as new as Empire did. And, you know, I kind of burned out on the whole archers and swords and spears and cavalry gameplay. You know, it didn't really feel like, you know, no matter the setting, they all kind of felt the same combat-wise. But Warhammer feels like it could shake that up. And I bought it in the Humble Monthly Bundle for like $12, so I figured, you know, why not? Let's give it a chance. Today, there's a new release of a free DLC for Britannia, and you can see them on the background here. This is the one of their kings that you can choose to play as. This is the Green Knight, who is apparently very famous. I'm not very familiar with the Warhammer fantasy lore. I'm more familiar with Warhammer 40,000, which I'm really into. But I'm not going to be playing as Britannia, because again, when I look at it, we're going to be playing the Old World Grand Campaign. When you look at Britannia, they are basically all about farmers holding the line and then having honorable knights charging into battle. And that pretty much feels like any other Total War I've ever played, with exception of, you know, these flying guys over here maybe. But they feel very familiar, and I want to do something that feels entirely new. So I'm not going to be playing as one of the human races. I am leaning towards the dwarves, because the dwarves, well, when have you ever had a game about awesome dwarves? You know. And the dwarves, as myself, they greatly value their beards. Basically, for a dwarf, his beard is his honor. And I really like that. Look at these guys, man. They're just small, they're sturdy, they have big armor, and they have even bigger beards. This is excellent. So, I'm going to be playing as the dwarves, because they get some cool artillery, they can hold the line really well, and yeah, I really like beard power. So, we have three faction leaders that we can choose from, but the one I'm going to be choosing is not the Forgrim Grudge Bearer. He is the vanilla character that you can choose to play with. He sits on his throne, carried by four guys, and he has the Book of Grudges right in front of him, or the Damask Crown, as he calls it. And, well, that's pretty awesome in a way, but, you know, its animations don't really look all that convincing, to be honest. Now we have Ungrim Iron Fist. And he's pretty damn cool as well. He has this big, long red mohawk. But the one I want to be playing with is Grumbrindal, the White Dwarf. He is a powerful melee fighter and leader. He has a powerful battle ability called Grumbrindal Has No Fear. He has, as his lord effects, evasion chance when using the underway plus 40%, reinforcement range plus 30, and can call upon the power of the ancient ancestor gods. And, I mean, just look at this intro video for him. The rage on his face is immense, and just this snarl, man, is just, I love it. So this is the guy that we're going to be playing with. And just one more time, this snarl, it's just too good. Yeah. Alright, we're going to be playing on hard difficulty, and we get some additional starting units. We get the Iron Drakes, we get Miners with blasting charges, and we get a Gyrocopter with a Brimstone Gun, which I think is a machine gun, but I'm not entirely sure. So, let's get started.
The old world is a crucible of relentless war. It has ever been so. An era as long as the month. the storms gather again, it presents a chance for the brave to bring about an age of reckoning. I come to the Dwarf High King as a herald of such times. And so I find myself at the King's right hand. My presence is timely, but dire news comes from the south. Greenskins flock to the banner of a cruel war boss. Now, my liege, Thorgrim Grudgebearer, leads a mighty throng from Karazakarak, smashing aside any foes that block our path. If Grudgebearer desires to return the Karaz Angkor to its former glory, then he must rid his lands of vile greenskins. Those gathering within the shadows of Everpeak are a good start. Hail to you, Grombrindle, ancestor of legend. You have secured Karazakarak, defended it from the greenskin fiends, and put their gutless horde to rout. Yet more remains undone. The bloody spears still infest the mountains to the east, setting up their hovels amidst your sacred pillars. Dwarven lands lay sullied by their sickening taint. You must be the hero of the ancient sagas, and march for their deliverance. To the south, yet more vicious Urki and Grobi lay ready to strike at your kin. Perhaps even the loathsome Black Goblin. Know that there are other dwarven lords who would gladly ally with one so legendary as you, for common cause. The dwarfs will know a new age of prosperity, heralded by the battle cry of Grombrindle, the White Dwarf.
Alright, so we're in the campaign map now, and we were just issued a grudge, and this is something that is unique to the dwarves. The dwarves, they basically have a great book called the Damascron, or the Book of Grudges, and basically every grudge that we get has to be settled. Alright, so every army we lose has to be avenged, every town that is burned has to be revenged. The dwarves cannot rest until every slight against their people has been revenged. So, we just were issued our first one, which is the Trespassing Greenskin Grudge. Beheld by the enraged gaze of Grimnir, the bloody spears have trespassed with impunity all over the sacred mountains. Their forces gather to the east and must be defeated in battle before their strength is regained. So our objective is to defeat an army belonging to the following faction, which is the Bloody Spears. And if we do so, we will get 1,000 gold. Alright, so we have our army over here, led by Grombrindle, the White Dwarf. He is standing outside of our sacred city, Karazakarak. And just look at that. It looks awesome, doesn't it? Look at that. All of these statues of dwarves with shields and stuff. Oh, man. So much detail in this world. It's kind of hard to read, though. You know, like all the passages and stuff like that. It's a little bit hard, so we're going to have to work a little bit. Like, this area over here is easier to read. It's more open. But the mountain passes with all the trees and stuff. Well, yeah, this is easy enough, but then... Look at that. How do we get to Grom Peak from here? You know, that's that's the problem there. Anyway, let's have a look. Grombrindle needs to move towards this army and attack it, but I'm not sure if I want to do it on this turn, because he is a legendary lord and he is really good in battle, but we have one unit of dwarf warriors, we have one unit of miners, we have another unit of miners with blasting charges, we have some iron drakes, we have quarrelers, we have gyrocopters. And the only real good guys at holding the line, as far as I know, are the dwarf warriors. So these guys, they're more specialized than miners. They can, you know, take out gates and stuff like that, and they can hold the line somewhat, but they're not really all that great at it, I think. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm just going to march my army forward, and then I'm going to recruit some new ones. And I'm going to recruit, so let's see, can we get, yeah, we can get 3 units of Dwarf Warriors. So once those are ready on the next turn, we will attack this army. Hopefully it will not move and it stays in range. Meanwhile, let's have a look at Karazakarak, because we have some construction options here. So we can upgrade the, let's see, what do we have here? Our sparring chamber, which unlocks recruitment of dwarf warriors with great weapons as soon as we get an armory, miners and miners with blasting charges as soon as we get the gunsmith's forge. But yeah, once we get clan barracks, we can unlock recruitment of quarrelers, which are the ranged guys, and we definitely need those, so let's go ahead and let's get that started. And then we have an open construction slot, and we can use either military stuff, but the only thing that we could build is a sparring chamber, and we already have one of those, so there's no need. There's the military support, but we need to have a level 3 keep before any of these are unlocked, and on top of that, these are all really expensive. Here is the armory though, and we are going to need it at some point, but we, as I said, we need a level 3 keep. We have a level 2 keep at the moment, and when we unlock a level 3 keep, we will actually unlock another construction slot. So for now, we can do something that is better for getting us some more money per turn. And we have a few options. We have a refectory, which is good for public order. This will give us public order plus 5. We could get a barley field, which is good for growth. Gets us more citizens, more recruits and stuff like that. We have a gem mineshaft, and its income generated per turn is 300. So I'm definitely leaning towards that one. But we also have a trading depot, and this one basically increases all the trade agreement tariffs faction-wide by 2%. Additional tradable resources, 2%. You know, this can be good in the long run, but in the early game, not as potent as it could be. And definitely not as potent as the gem mineshaft. So, that's the one that we are going to be building, and then we are almost out of money. So, last thing that we need to do, is or one of the 2 last things, is we can have a look at diplomacy.
Relations with foreign powers may be managed through diplomacy, my lord.
Yeah, alright, sure. As you can see, we are now in a 2D map, and all of the red areas are belonging to enemies of ours, and they are all green skins. The green area is another dwarven clan called the Baragvar, and by the looks of it, let's see, we already have a trade agreement with them. We also have a non-aggression pact and military access. Now, we could open more agreements with them and see if we can add a defensive alliance to that. And the likelihood of success is moderate, so let's propose it. Oh, and they accepted. Right. So, now we have a defensive alliance, which means that if somebody declares war on us, the Baragvar will come to help us out. And that's pretty much the only trade routes at the moment that we can open up, and we already opened that automatically, so nothing that we can do there anymore. And lastly, we have the technology tree, and we have a few options. We can go the way of the guilds or the way of the clans. The way of the clans is basically good for war. The way of the guilds is basically good for economy. And at the early game, we need all the money we can get. So I'm leaning towards either the Khazid subsidies, which is an income from settlements plus 5%, or include related families, which is good for public order, and we need that as well in the early game, but probably we need the money more. So Khazid subsidies it is. All right, let's end this turn. Ah, they come to attack us. All right, well, let's see, we get situation mustering, builds up his army strength. You currently have units queued for recruitments. Campaign movement, and then we have Grumbrindal's Fury. Perhaps it is the combined help of all the gods, or maybe some hidden power within him, but when Grumbrindal summons forth all his might, no known foe can match him in single combat. Melee attack plus 10 for Grumbrindal, melee defense plus 15, and weapon strength plus 30. Wow. Alright, so we are going to have to hold the line against this enemy before we are reinforced, but that's fine. We have lots of units that are good at range. And we can even get the gyrocopter to flank around the rear. So let's go ahead and fight this battle. Alright, so we have the Battle of Karazakarak. Alright, so we're on the battlefield, and let's have a look around. We have this, we have a rock over here. We basically have to find the most advantageous ground for us, and we probably want to do that on the, the small hilltop over here. It's not big, it's not huge, but it might help us a little bit. And at this point, we have Dwarf Warriors. Let's stretch them out a little bit. And then we have Miners. They will also have to hold the front line for us. And then we have Miners with Blasting Charges, and I kind of want to use them on the front line as well, but at the same time, I kind of want to use them to throw, let's see, they can throw explosives. And so maybe the best thing to do would be to hold them in the back for now, so they can throw some grenades first before they are actually charged. Then we have the Gyrocopter, he can stay off to the right-hand side over here. We have Quarrelers, who will be in the front line, and they will also be in skirmish mode. We have the Iron Drakes, who will also be at the front line and in skirmish mode, so they can fire off first, and then they can retreat behind the Dwarf Warriors over here. And then we have Grombrindal, and he's going to be in the center of the front line here, like right there in the middle of his dwarves, and he can go left or right depending on where we need him, because we are slightly outnumbered by the Greenskins, I think. Alright, and let's see, what do we want to do with this? Maybe keep them on the side there. Are they hidden in here? Probably not. But, the idea is there. Could we hide the Quarrelers in here? Yes, they are hidden from sight. And they have quite a long range as well, so maybe... Look at that. Maybe we could hide them from the trees. And then, that would be a good idea, maybe. Alright, let's go ahead and try that out. Let's start this battle. Alright, these guys are hidden. Are they sneaking? No, they're not really sneaking. Sneaking is not great for dwarves. Alright, so, our guys are standing in line. Here we've got our Dwarf Warriors with their shields and their axes, looking all awesome and glorious with their mighty beards. Look at that. Man, I'm so jealous right now. We have our Iron Drakes in the front, and these guys, they hold flamethrowers. Look at that. And they even have beard armor to stop their beards from melting off. That is just awesome. Alright, in the middle we have Grombrindal, the White Dwarf, with his mighty axe. Look at that, how awesome that is. Now we have Miners with pickaxes and hammers. Not all that great. Right, and maybe... Maybe we should turn these guys around a little bit. Maybe... These guys need to move up into the flank as well, so they can actually fire at the enemy. And then these guys, definitely, I spend too much time looking at my enemies. Not good. Oh, maybe not, yeah, fire at these guys. Fire at the orc boys, guys, come on. There we go. Alright, Grombrindal. Let's get you moving forward into the Greenskin Horde. Look at that. That is awesome. Alright, you guys can charge forward. You guys need to charge forward. You need to hurt these archers, and these guys need to hurt the archers as well. Alright, the Miners. These guys should definitely stop firing at this point. These guys need to attack Gnashrak, the enemy general. They can reinforce the center. Jesus Christ, look at these orc biggins. Alright, maybe... My helicopter needs to help out with that. Maybe these guys need to help out with the orc biggins as well, because Jesus Christ, these guys are getting picked apart. Maybe these guys need to move off to the flank so they can shoot into the rear of the enemy orcs. Well, all orcs are enemies. The enemy lord is wounded. Alright, that helps us greatly. Then Grumbrindal can help out there. The miners with the blasting charges need to help out their brothers on the right flank. Jesus Christ, guys, move. Ooh, these guys are running away. That is excellent news. Alright. Grumbrindal needs to help out the miners. Definitely. You guys need to move forward. You guys need to maybe shoot at the Orc Error boys. Look at that. We have Orc boys. Two units of Orc boys in the middle. And my guys are routing. Maybe this is a good time to use Grumbrindal Has No Fear. Affects allies in range, map wide. Unbreakable. These guys will not break as long as Grumbrindal is in the fight. Or at least they won't break for a little while. Right, maybe these guys, the Dwarf Warriors, need to help out in the rear there. These guys can do this. These guys can fire at those guys. These guys need to fire at them as well. Look at that. These guys can run into the enemy rear under cover of overwhelming firepower. Look at that. Oh, man. That is awesome. All right. Let's look at this charge. In come the mighty dwarves, jumping in at the bigger orcs. Like, these orcs are like twice the size of a dwarf. And they're just getting their asses kicked. Because, well, they don't have glorious beards like we do. Victory! Miners, only 8 left, but at least they didn't rout for very long. Alright, let's go after the orc biggins. These guys as well. These guys as well. You guys need to charge after the running orcs. We want to kill as many orc boys here as we can. These iron drakes are not going to be doing much for us, I don't think. Maybe they can kill this one guy. Maybe not. You guys, oh, they have an ammo bar. So by the looks of it, they're almost out of ammo. Alright, so look at these guys in their heavy armor and covered in blood. Ouch. Oh man, one of those guys got cut in half. Look at that. Excellent. Alright, these dwarves on their short legs. Oh man, it seems unlikely they're going to catch up to these orc boys, but let's give them another order. Usually they charge a little bit faster immediately after you give an order, so yeah, some orcs are getting caught. Got a few axes to the back, but ooh, there we go. Look at that. Off with his head. Some more dead orcs. Let's leave a trail of dead bodies. One of the units has used all its ammunition. Well, I guess that is the... yeah. Alright. Can you actually... come on, shoot, guys. There we go. One final barrage into the enemy's back. Excellent. Alright, let's end this battle. That's a Pyrrhic victory, but, well, we expected that because we didn't have quite the same amount of frontline units in 40. We have 167 remaining, but at least none of our units were completely wiped out. Alright. So, we get some loot, 297 gold, that's good. We gain some XP, so we leveled up. And... now we can do that later on, I think. Now we get to choose what we do with the survivors. And of course, the greenskins are our native enemy. Our ancient enemy, in fact. And we could release them. We get some more money for that, but who wants to release orcs back into the wild, right? Execute them all. Alright, the Bloody Spears retreat into the Pillars of Grungni. Scabby Eye is moving forward with an army. Grudge successful. Alright, so we get 1,000 extra gold. Excellent.
Grungni maintain one of their slum camps beneath the Pillars of Grungni. A sin that cannot remain in the Damask Kron any longer. The Pillars must be returned to Dwarven hands.
Right, I agree. Alright, so... we got some new Dwarf Warriors. These guys are reinforcing, but that's only for the next turn. So once I move outside of friendly territory, they are no longer being reinforced. But we have enough units to make this work. So, let's go towards the Pillars of Grungni and have a look. Well, let's see, they have Krugluk, the Bloody Spears, and Stitch Up Spear Chaka. Actually, for now, let's encircle the enemy. They don't have any walls, so we don't need the siege. Because first thing I want to do is want to have a look at his... Wait, what? He doesn't have a skill point? I thought he leveled up. Right. That is interesting. I guess they are all rank 1, I suppose. Alright. Then what do we want to do? We are... Yeah, the balance of power is just greatly in our favor, so I'm not really sure if we want to fight this battle. Let's see, executed captives, we have plus 4 leadership. Grombrindal's Fury, and laying siege. So we have another general over here, Stitch Up Spear Chaka. I killed the last guy that they sent my way. This is a goblin general, and then we have some orc boys. Krugluk, I guess, is a special unit. I'm not entirely sure. We have some goblins with spears. They should be easy enough to break. Now we have some orc error boys and goblin archers. But these guys are all pretty damaged as well, so I'm not too worried about these guys for now. Let's go ahead and fight this battle as well. This should be over pretty quickly. Alright, oh, we're on a wintry map. That is awesome. And we have mountains surrounding us. Oh, that looks really good, actually. Wow. That is something that is definitely improved from previous Total War games, I think. Alright, so we are in our starting position. Let's have a look. Miners can start anywhere they want outside of the... Well, up to a certain degree. It's hard to see on the white, but you can see this white area leading around this our deployment zone. And these guys, they can start in that area if we want to. But these guys are pretty damaged, so we're not going to do that. We are going to take all of our dwarven warriors, and we're going to stretch them out a little bit into a nice battle line. We are going to take the Iron Drakes and the Quarrelers. We're going to stretch those guys out in front of our army. Grombrindal should be in the front a little bit. These guys are going to be in the rear and maybe reinforce the battle line wherever we need them to. And these guys, the gyrocopters, I feel like they would be best served on the right hand flank. Is this water? No, it's just ground. Alright. Then maybe they are... Yeah, they should be better off in open ground. So these guys are going to be on the right flank. Alright, let's group all of these together. Let's see, group, set formation, missile front, melee front. Toggle group lock. Locked groups preserve the relative positions and facings of their units from the point at which the group was created. Default group behavior, yeah, okay, that's what I wanted. Alright, let's start this battle. Looks like the enemy is over there, so let's... Here, look at that, it doesn't work. Alright, so let's create a new battle line. I don't know why that doesn't work the way it's supposed to. Because I locked the unit, so they really should. Alright, let's get Grombrindal out in front. Of course, our gyrocopters need to move towards the flank, they need to move forward a little bit. Looks like this time around the enemy is just... is okay with just waiting us out. We have our orc boys over here. We have some goblins with spears. Look at these guys in their what looks like winter gear, like, you know, the fur hats and everything. We have some goblin archers. Krugluk, sword infantry. I suppose these guys would be a priority for us. Orc boys in the back, orc arrow boys. Some more goblins, some more orc boys. Right, my guys have reached their position, but I'm not sure why this isn't locked. Toggle group lock. Ah, alright. I guess it makes sense now. Now it works. Alright. Just needed to figure that out for a second there. Alright, let's send our helicopter really far around the flank, and maybe we can do some damage with the spear infantry, or... Well, we probably should target all the heavier troops, right, and damage them as much as we can. But man, look at the glory of my dwarven army marching forward. And Grombrindal leading the way. Of course, I should remember that these guys should all be in skirmish mode, since they are in front of the army and they are very piss poor in melee. Maybe, no, target these orc boys. We're going to draw some fire, but these guys are armored and they should be able to take a few hits of volleys, I think. I just really want to damage these guys up a little bit. Looks like the army is splitting up. Interesting. Look at that. Free kill straight off the bat. Oh, these guys are taking some damage, which is really bad. Alright, let's run our army up into the high ground there, so they can take some pot shots at the approaching enemy army. These guys did a pretty good job at breaking up the enemy lines. I can keep them around to harass the enemy from the rear. There we go. Our quarrelers are on the attack. They're shooting at goblins. Yeah, goblins would be okay, I guess. As soon as they break... Well, actually, let's target these orc boys. They're already pretty damaged, and so... Alright, so the archers are staying in the rear. These guys need to move forward. Alright. The miners with blasting charges should run forward as well, so they can throw some stuff for us. Maybe attack these goblins. Look at these guys just exploding at the front line there. Let's have you target those guys. Let's have Grombrindal charge into the enemy right there. My lord is under attack, yes I know. These guys need to fall back. And then they need to stop fire at will. Let's get these guys into the fight. These dwarf warriors are holding the line against the goblins pretty well. That's good news. Maybe these miners should move around the flank there. These guys... can charge into the flank. Where is Grombrindal? Alright, he is holding his own against Krugluk and the orc boys over there. Let's use a special ability again. Stitch of Spear Trap. Ah, here's the enemy... enemy hero. Wow. There goes one of my dwarves. Our flamethrower infantry needs to retreat to the rear because I don't want them to be damaged. Yeah, these guys need to move forward and deal some damage to the enemy archers. These guys are holding their own pretty damn well. And you should probably attack these guys as well. I forgot all about that target of opportunity there. Let's see, where's Grombrindal? These guys are running away. Let's destroy the orc boys then. So let's have a look at these guys. Oh, so they have like little cannons up at the front there. Yeah. I know, these guys are just being thrown back and there's just body parts everywhere. Blood on the ground. Krugluk are retreating. It's excellent news. These guys are holding the line, which is great. These guys need to turn around and maybe... These orc boys are retreating as well. These dwarf warriors, well, they've been thinned out quite significantly, but they've held the line remarkably well. Alright, let's get Grombrindal. No, Grombrindal should deal with the enemy hero. These dwarf warriors can help their buddies over there. Or actually, let's attack these orc boys. The Krutluker have come back. So let's have a look at that charge. These guys are jumping up at each other. Alright, the Iron Drakes need to move forward. These guys can... Yeah, they're so beat up that they might as well just keep chasing the Orc Boys there. Victory! All of these guys are retreating now. Excellent. Alright. Look at this. Grombrindal just chasing after the enemy general. Not in any kind of a hurry. Come on, guy. He's just not bothered to run after the enemy at all. He's just like, okay, I can deal with this. This is fine. They're not gonna do shit. Let's have a look. Our archers are really damn powerful. This stinks. Well, it stinks for you, it's good for us. Can we get off another shot? No, they cannot get off another shot, that's unfortunate. Our helicopters, however, yeah, they've run out of ammunition as well, but I think they can actually use melee as well. They're just gonna circle low and hit people with their rotors. But man, look at that. Look at these guys, their awesome beards in the helicopter. That's just hilarious. Oh man, just corpses everywhere. Few brave dwarves have given their lives, but overall, everybody held the line really, really well. That's primarily the strength of the dwarves. Alright, let's end this battle here. Decisive victory. Excellent. So we lost 104. Not too great, but not too bad. There we go, close victory. Got some more loot. This province is now ours, which means that we can occupy it, which is our goal, which will give us some more money. And we killed Stitch Up Spear Chaka in battle. Excellent. Our grudge against the Pillars of Grongni grudge has been completed. We get 1,000 more gold.
Your Dawi have been put to work fixing up the captured city, sir. Yet there are many grudges still to settle. Perfidious manlings and bloodthirsty vampires threaten your kind in the north. And your...
Yeah. Alright. So, a new chapter objective has been issued. The reckoning begins. The Karas Angkor has fallen into decline, assaulted by fell enemies above and below ground, but no more. Everpeak has stirred. The High King demands that the Dwarf Realm be brought back to its former glory. Let the task begin in earnest. Right, so occupy, loot, raise, or sack 3 different settlements, and for that we get plus 2,000. Excellent.
Helicopter scouts report of a greenskin migration heading northwards. Spies say they intend to meet up and swell the mobs of a great orc warlord who travels towards the Badlands. Whatever they are to, they must be stopped. Summon the throng.
Alright, so this is something that is new to Total Warhammer as well, or Total Warhammer. And that is quests. So we have a quest, which is a special battle. It's a designed battle. It's not just a random army that you encounter on the map somewhere. This one is, you know, like the historical battles of previous Total Wars. It is set up to play out in a certain way. So we have the ambush at the Thundering Falls. And as a reward, we will get a hero, a runesmith, and we can get an item, which is Dragon Helm, which will give us plus 4 armor and fire resistance plus 25%. But of course, we have to get there first. We could teleport there, but of course, I'm not going to do that in this episode because then the video will be way too long. What I will do, however, is level up Grombrindal because finally he does have a skill point. And we can do this in 3 separate groups. So we have full plate armor. This is basically melee for for Grumbrindal, so this makes him a better warrior. We have Inspiring Presence, which makes our army stronger. And then we have, sort of like a commercial tree. So we have Ancient Acumen, all unit experience plus one for all unit recruits. That is very powerful. It's faction-wide as well. Recruitment cost minus 5% for land units, etc., etc. So actually this one is pretty damn powerful, and especially Legendary Commerce is income from trade plus 20% on trade agreement tariffs. I think this is very powerful indeed. Otherwise, I might go for Inspiring Presence. There are lords that radiate power, confidence, and fear, inspiring their followers to great or terrible acts, and this will... the aura of the leadership effects is plus 5. So any unit standing within this character's aura in battle will receive a leadership bonus. That is a very powerful thing. For the early battles, it might be very powerful. Actually, I might go with this first, then Legendary Commerce second, because we only have the one trade agreement at the moment, so this will be more powerful for us in the early game. Alright, now let's have a look at the Pillars of Grungni. So we have a dwarf mining colony in here. We have to wait until a population grows before we can upgrade it to the next settlement status. But the first thing we can do here is we can build some more stuff. And at this point, I feel like a barley field. Because we can either do a trinket maker, which gives us plus 200 extra income. And that's pretty powerful as well. But we also need to grow our cities to go to higher levels. So the barley field. Growth plus 15. Casualty replenishment rate plus 2%. I think this is the best one for now. Alright, let's go to the next turn. Luckily, this stuff passes by really quickly. Alright, the Living Ancestor. Such is the age and renown of the White Dwarf that many sagas say he strode with the Ancestor Gods themselves. It is a claim the White Dwarf does not refute, and no one dares challenge. For to doubt Grumbrindal's word or call him false would surely end badly for the accuser. Alright, so this is something that is unique to Grumbrindal apparently, and we can get a choice of 4 different things. And they will all benefit us in some great way for 25 turns. So we have Kin of Grimnir, and there is no god a dwarf would rather watch over them in battle. Grimnir's gaze is directed firmly at Grumbrindal's force. And so this will give our army melee attack plus 10 for melee defense of plus 10, and plus 10% for missile unit reload time reduction. So this will make our army a powerhouse, and we do need it in the early game. We have also Grungni's teachings, research rate plus 20%, upkeep minus 20% for all units in Grumbrindal's army, construction cost minus 10, recruitment cost minus 10. We have the White Dwarf, which makes Grumbrindal more powerful, and then Valea's protection. Enemy wins of magic power reserve minus 15, casualty replenishment rate plus 20, public order plus 10. That is pretty powerful as well in this early game, because we have a fairly upset province at the moment. But I want to increase my army's strength, so let's go for Kin of Grimnir. Trade gained. Favored. The crowds favor this one. Public order plus 1. Oh, nice. I am the White Dwarf. Alright, so we have another skill point to spend. Let's spend this one on Legendary Commerce. Extra money is always good. The dwarfs need me. Yeah, alright, we're going to stay here for this turn, but I'm going to put a cut in this episode right here, because I think it's been going on for quite long enough. Please like the video and leave a comment below if you enjoyed this video and want to see more, and I'll see you guys for whatever video I do next.